Hello everybody, and welcome to HONORLESS, a Skyrim SE Let's Play. Featuring Kinua, our Redguard shaman, who is currently on screen. As you can see, I have picked the camping in the woods start. So we've got our tent all set up, we've got our bag full of whatever we brought with us, which looks like a lot of- why do we have a pie? It looks like just a lot of food. I'll take the lockpicks and the gold. Salt. I mean, I'm not really going to be playing her as a pickpocket, so she can wear one of those rings, I guess. Not much in there useful at the moment. So welcome! Welcome to Skyrim. Welcome to... Kinua. Has just arrived in Skyrim, so welcome Kinua to Skyrim. She has just woken up from a very interesting dream. As she laid down for bed last night, when she rolled up in her bedroll, went to sleep after having arrived in this strange new world, she dreamed about a dragon flying over her camp, among other things. So, yeah, she's kind of wondering what in the world that was about, what's going on here, whether or not this was a sign from Tava. Speaking of Tava, actually, I wonder if we can equip that axe. Can we? We can favorite it? Can we actually use... the axe? I didn't know you could do that. Okay. Okay, that's cool. Okay, I didn't know you could... That was just... Alright, so I guess we know what her current one-handed weapon is. I didn't know you could equip an axe. A wood-cutting axe, anyway. I probably should have, since it does have a damage... a damage thing, but... Let's see, let's get her helmet back on. So, what was I going to say? Tava. She wields a bow because of Tava, because of hawks and eagles and everything. Oh, look at that. Look at the light. Look at how the light's shining through the fog up there. That's kind of cool. That's really cool. That's sort of... where she saw the dragon fly overhead in her dream, also. Oh! There's a bird over there. I couldn't really see it. I think we're gonna go up here, though. That's pretty sweet. Alright, so let's go up here, get a look around, see what's in the area that the dragon dream might have been trying to point her at. Oh! Look at that. We have a camp. I don't know if, or she doesn't know, I do. She doesn't know if this is a bandit camp, if this is just hunters out in the middle of the woods. It could be any number of things. By the way, I have a feeling that there's going to be a lot of rock hopping in this Let's Play, just because, you know, shamans tend to be out in the woods a lot. Gathering ingredients and communing with nature and all that jazz. Okay, so we've got someone down there. We've got a fire going. Someone's got a wood axe. Let's see. I don't know if I'm going to stick with this, but for the moment, let's take some precautions, shall we? Just in case. Just in case those guys mean business, and not in a good way. Oh, hey bird. Oh! Look at that! I'm gonna say that's our first tangible sign of this Let's Play, which is, let's go investigate this camp. Okay, there they are. Let's see. That guy, has he? He looks like he's seen us. He's got his. Yeah. Oh. Oh, he's got his bow out. That looks bad. That. Ooh. All right. I don't want any trouble, guys. I don't want any trouble. That's a little disconcerting. Look, the road is right there. So they might be bandits. Yeah. That. Huh. Now, Kinua isn't an idiot, but she's also new here. So I don't think she quite has any reason to distrust random. Why are they doing that? Out of character. That's a little weird. Okay. That's fine. But she doesn't have any reason to distrust them other than the drawn weapons, so she's going to approach with caution. What's up, guys? You, what you doing out? Oh!
Bad time to get lost,
nope.
Friend.
Oh! That was good. That was good. What? 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 What is... That'll do. Suspend your disbelief for a moment while I figure this out. She, yeah, I guess she just got so panicked that she forgot to put her bow away? What happened there? There we go. Oh, archer. Archer, bad news. Bad news. Oh, let's get the bow out. Oop. Nice. Nice! Wow. Okay. Okay, bird, we've investigated. Wow. Okay, Kinua was a good archer, I guess. Oh, there he is. There's that little bird. Okay. So I guess that was a spirit bird. There's a sign. Oh, wow. Look at that shield. That is really cool. With the green and the arrows, it kind of... It has a very Tava-esque feel to it. I think we'll take it. Yeah. Might take his axe, too, just in case. She won't fit in any of that armor. And I don't think she'd want it anyway, given that it's probably all covered in blood and gore right now. It's probably also a little singed. Now this guy. Yikes. Ooh. Take that. I'll take his backpack. That seems useful. Arrows, always helpful. I'm not... Wait, hold on. What kind of bow am I using? Oh, okay. See, I've got a bow mod installed, so I have a hard time telling what kind of bow I'm using at the moment. There go the birds again. I don't know what happened there with the audio, but that's fine. I'll take his cloak. Ooh, look at that thing. Take it. Let's see what that looks like. I have a weapons mod installed. It adds more weapons, such as this lovely short spear. I think the mod's called Heavy Armory. That's cool. I'm gonna try that out. And the bow mod is better shaped bows, so... Nice! That's actually not bad. That's not as... Oop. We seem to have pissed off the birds. Sorry, guys! Put it away. I have a birds mod. I have SkyBirds installed as well. The mod list is in the description. I probably don't need to keep mentioning it. I'm still working out all of the kinks. Obviously, since this is my first episode. I also should probably say that it's probably gonna be a... Ignore that ancient ring, that's for a different mod also. That I probably won't use in this particular Let's Play, but it's there and I'm too lazy to not have it there on the off chance that we end up using it. What was I going to say? I got distracted. Is anybody else in there? We're gonna proceed with a bit of caution. Probably. Let's see. Well. Oh. Oh, look at that. There he goes. And there's another one up there. So I'm gonna be interpreting a lot of bird calls and bird signs because, oop, someone alerted the birds again. I'll take the fish. What was I talking about? Oh, it's gonna probably be a bit of a slow burn getting started because I'm... this is my first Let's Play, so... Yeah, I have the advantage of my father is a narrator. Ooh, that's handy. Ooh, Sentinel. Night falls on Sentinel. So, we're gonna take that one because Sentinel is a place in Hammerfell. And she is probably from Sentinel or somewhere nearby Sentinel. But yeah, my father does narration and podcasting sometimes. So he has a recording booth set up. Where's my camp? I seem to have lost my camp. Oop, come on. Come on. We can do it. We can't do it. Okay. That's fine. That's fine. So I hope everybody's doing well. Oop, fox. There's another sign. I don't have every animal in the game associated with various and sundry Yokuden. Oop, thistle. Grab that. Various and sundry Yokuden deities. Big barrow over there. That looks interesting to Kinua. She has not seen architecture like that, I don't think. Bluebirds. Ooh. Ooh. Bluebirds. I wonder what's over here. That fox led us over here. Now we've got birds, so. Birds I have associated with Tava, who is the Yokuden goddess of air and basically the Yokuden version of Kinnereth. So, you know, makes sense. And Tava is sort of, as I mentioned in the... Come on. Nice. What the heck was that one? I heard one in the background. I don't know what it was. Okay. Any more of these? No? Sad. Okay. As I mentioned in the introduction video, Tava is her matron goddess. She considers... Okay, and there's that weird fortress that we saw in the dream. She is going to avoid that for now because of that... that dragon thing, she considers that to be a warning right at the moment, not to go there. But she is going to look around and see what else is in the area, because, I mean, you know, she just sort of walked up and set up camp. My guess is that she was tired from walking and riding and whatever else from Hammerfell, so. Yeah. Okay, let's take whatever's in here. Just in case we end up, you know, leaving this camp behind for somewhere else. We might come back, who knows. Which way do we want to go? Oh, Fox! That's what I forgot. Foxes I have associated with Leki, or... Is that? Yeah, Leki. Who is... Oh, let's put that, let's put our bag on, since we picked up all that loot. And the cloak? There it is. Oops, I dropped it. Stop. That's fine. Forgive the random button pressing. I'm still trying to get used to this. This could be a slow start to this adventure. But, you know what? We're here. We're going. But that fox, Leki, who there isn't really much information. There goes a bird. Let's follow it around this way. There isn't a whole lot of information out there on Yakudin deities. So I've basically gone on what I've learned from listening to the Elder Lore podcast and reading the wiki page. So let's see if we can get up here. So basically in my mind, I have associated Leki with foxes because it sounds like Loki. So I imagine that Leki is very similar, like a... Wow. Wow. Okay. Can we all just take a minute to appreciate that this Redguard is seeing this for the first time in her life? And this is a landscape that she has dreamed of, literally dreamed of, since she was a kid. And here she is. Like, this is a moment of, for her, oh my god, this is real, this is happening. I'm here now. And now what do I do? So, yeah. The barrow seems like an interesting place to be. There's camp. Oop. I guess we're going down this way. That's fine. Let's see what's over in this direction. Presumably she came from that direction. Because the southeast roughly is the direction that Hammerfell is in. So presumably she came up this way and just decided to set up camp, but if she got here late and set up and just fell asleep, I don't think she would have had too much time to explore around the area. So let's see what we can find out here. There's the road. Flowers. She will be an alchemist at some point. Let's see. Yeah, we saw this from up there. Just briefly. But we saw the fire. Let's see. Oop. What was that? What did we just see? Was that a wolf? Was it a fox? Oh, there it is. A couple of... elk? Caribou? I think they're labeled as elk in the game, but they look more like caribou to me. Alright. Proceed with caution. Bear trap. That's not good. That's not good for the wildlife. Yeah, she has no qualms about picking flowers because she knows how much to take and how much to leave to make sure the plant grows back again. Let's make sure there aren't any more bear traps that are yet to be sprung around here. I don't want anything stepping foot in one of them traps. Let's grab some honey. And we'll leave the rest because we don't want to piss off the bees too much. That seems like a bad idea. This seems really, really suspicious, actually. Hello? Hello? Okay. That's fine. So, they're poachers, I guess. Given the bear traps and the rabbit sitting on the thing. I don't know what we'll ever be able to do with sacks of flour, but I'll take the apples. Tanning rack. Bedroll. So the fire is still burning. Which means that this camp is probably not completely abandoned. But I don't see where anyone could be hiding. Those two elk, kinda. It's interesting that they're still here. So that means that whoever was here has left long enough ago that the wildlife isn't terribly concerned with being here. I'll take that potion. Ooh. Nice. Snazzy. Come on. There we go. She's not opposed to picking locks. Take the gold. Lockpick. Could come in handy. But we're not gonna take those gloves. Oh! Oh! Whoop! 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 There they are! Hi guys! Oh, and they're all archers! Oh, this is probably bad. Come on. Come on! That is correct. Yeah, good luck. Where is he? There he is. Got him. Got him. Oop, he got me. Where's that Khajiit? There he is. Oop. Come on, get back up. Or not. Ah. That's fine. Let me put my shield back on just in case. Take your lockpick. Take your arrows. Gonna leave the rest of it though. So, there's a bunch of poachers down. Take the wine? Yeah, might as well. Take the arrow. Oh, that's my arrow. Take your arrows. You never know when you might need more arrows. Until you get to higher levels, in which case you're just crawling with them. Crawling with arrows. Pincushion Peter. I think that's actually a place. But I don't know where it is. Okay. Let's go see what those elk are up to, maybe. Because they didn't seem at all bothered by the amount of noise that we just made. We're gonna be sneaky. Sort of. And away they go. Bump bump. Oop. Thought I heard something. Let's see. Snowberry. Why not? I think this is the way back to our camp. Yes, yes it is. Oh, and there goes another one. Was that one of the ones we were chasing, or no? Oh yeah, there goes the other one. Let's see where that one went. Okay. So the other bandit camp is just down there. So, let's see. Let's go. Oh yeah, we took out these guys. Yeah, forgot. That's fine. Let's go check out these stumps over here. Because somebody must have been in the area cutting them down, right? Wow. So that's Lake Illinalta. Probably. There's a dead wolf. I think that's a wolf. It's either a wolf or a skeever. That is a wolf. I bet those bandits got him. If not, we should probably be careful. Yeah, the birds aren't happy. Birds aren't happy, but we'll take the pelt. Thank you for your sacrifice. And we're gonna back away slowly and go the other direction. Oop, there's that deer again. Elk, whatever that is. Reindeer. Reindeers are the domestic ones, I think. Oh, hi. Who are you? Hello?
The life of adventure and song is the life for us, eh, friend?
Yeah. What are you doing out here? Anyway, it's kind of out of the way.
Why, to perform for my common man, of course. Why should only the courts and inns of wealthy towns be given the gift of music?
That's pretty honorable. You think maybe you could teach me how to, you know, get along with people better here? You know, because Nords.
Ah, well, after a little incident with a roguish lad and the daughter of a prominent Thane. Well, let's just say, best not. Afraid not. But if you're serious about sharpening that tongue, you might try the Bard's College in solitude. Aye.
Why, thank you, and good day. But no thank you. I don't think we'll ever be a bard. I don't think she's interested. Interesting to meet somebody out here, though. Just wandering around. Noble guy. Let's see what's up here. And there's that barrow. Who are they? There goes a rabbit. Sorry for the jerky camera there. Wonder what they're about. That's interesting. Time check. It's a little late for... Well, maybe it isn't. I assume the sun sets earlier in Skyrim than she's used to. Oh. Oh boy. What happened here? Yikes. Worshippers of a god that she doesn't recognize. But she does recognize it as a shrine. Why are these people dead? Okay. This uniform looks familiar, but we're just gonna... Come on. Come on. Come on. That was ungraceful. But we're gonna flip him over just to make sure. Yeah, he's Altmer. This is a Thalmor. Thalmor orders. We're not gonna take any of his stuff, I don't think. Except the orders. Huh. That's... Wow. A monk? Some random worshiper. I assume that's her husband, and another monk. Alright. Come on. Let's get you out of the way. So, because she does recognize it as a shrine, and because she recognizes that this god might be somehow watching over the souls of the people who died here, she is going to leave... Yeah, we'll leave a garnet here. Just as a kind of symbol of goodwill, I guess. And the sun is setting rapidly. It is getting dark. It is getting dark real fast. She is not used to living or being really somewhere that the sun takes its sweet time rising and sets real fast. And much earlier than she's used to. So we're gonna try to find our camp in the dark. Oh wow. I should really do something about this. I hope y'all can see okay, because I can't. This is bad. Where is my camp? Okay, there's fog up there. I think the light will probably be better. Let's go toward the fog and see if we can find our way back. Oh, this is bad. Okay, where's camp? Oop. Oop, come on. Come on. There it is. Ah, okay. We're home. We're back. We made it. First successful day in Skyrim. Let's check out these orders. Agent Sanyan, in response to your report dated 22nd Morningstar 401, your request for an expeditionary wow, force is hereby denied. Sanyan, this is the 7th report you have filed this month, and not one of your leads, has turned up so much as a shred of evidence that a Talos shrine exists in the Lake Illinalto region. No prisoners? Ooh. No documents? Nothing. Our forces are stretched thin enough as it is, and I have better missions, better agents to assign to them. If you feel so sure of your informant, investigate this yourself. Come back with proof, or not at all. Yeah, that's threatening. Let me see if I can do something about the night brightness real quick. Ooh, I'm getting some issues here. That's fine. Come on. Come on. There we go. Alright. Let's see if that did anything. It doesn't look like it helped much. That's okay. That's okay, I guess. So this is, she just came out of a place where the Thalmor are considered the scum of the earth. And now she's here again. Back in a place where there are Thalmor just running around. Anyway. So now she knows that there is a problem between Talos, who is the god that... She now knows that that is the god that she was looking at. The statue, anyway. Between Talos and the Thalmor. And I don't know if she knows what to make of this. Let's grab some dinner while we're at it. We should probably eat that pie before it goes bad. I've considered installing I Need, but I think I'm gonna wait until... Yeah, let's have some pie. I think I'm gonna wait until I have a better handle on what I'm doing here. So, it's getting late. It's getting dark. And I think now would be an excellent time for Kinua to settle in and get some rest. And think about what she's learned about Talos and about the Thalmor and about Skyrim. So, With that, I will draw this episode to a close, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, have a good one.